This tiny teach is about osmosis. Osmosis is movement of water from an area of high water concentration to an area of low water concentration. Sometimes people want to just learn osmosis as the diffusion of water. The problem with using that definition is it's not going to help us figure out if water is going to osmose, and if it is, in what direction is it going to osmose. So we really want to use osmosis as movement of water from an area of high water concentration to an area of low water concentration. Now let's do some terminology that's going to help us with this osmosis tiny teach. We've all made Kool-Aid where we've taken drink mix, a solute, and added to water, a solvent, to actually produce a solution. You can make Kool-Aid in different ways. You could use almost no Kool-Aid drink mix and have a really dilute version of Kool-Aid. You could add tons and tons and tons of drink mix and have a really, really strong Kool-Aid. Or you can add just the right amount of Kool-Aid powder to water and just get perfect Kool-Aid solution. The reason that we want to talk about this is we're going to talk about osmosis for a cell. And a cell has a selectively permeable membrane. What a cell wants is equilibrium across its membrane, the same amount of stuff on the inside of the cell as on the outside of the cell. If there isn't equilibrium across the membrane, then some sort of membrane transport is going to happen. And in this case, we're focusing on osmosis. In order to figure out if osmosis is going to take place and in what direction, we have to look at what solution is the cell sitting in versus the cell itself. Is it at equilibrium? If not, then osmosis is going to occur. So a hypotonic solution contains more solvent than solute. This is our really weak Kool-Aid solution where we added only a little bit of the drink mix powder. A hypertonic solution contains more solute than solvent. This is our Kool-Aid where we added lots and lots and lots of powder drink mix, and it's really, really strong. And then an isotonic solution has equal amounts of solute and solvent. This is where we made our Kool-Aid to have just the right amount of Kool-Aid powder and water. Now let's put all of this background information to work. Figure out, is the cell at equilibrium? If not, osmosis will occur. And if it is going to occur, in what direction? And then what's going to happen to the cell? So let's start with the isotonic solution beaker. An isotonic solution means that it has the same amount of solutes in the beaker, in the solution, as it does inside the cell. And you can see in the picture, there's about the same number of purple polka dots in the cell as in the solution in the beaker. That means that this cell is already at equilibrium with its environment, so no membrane transport is necessary, so no osmosis will take place. In the middle beaker, we have a hypertonic solution. That means there's more solute in the solution surrounding the cell than what's inside the cell. And you can see tons of the purple blue polka dots in the beaker, but very few on the inside of the cell. That means this cell is not at equilibrium, and osmosis is going to take place until that cell is at equilibrium. The solute, whether it's sugar or salt, it can't move to correct this problem. Only water can move, and water is going to move by osmosis. So water is going to osmose from an area of high water concentration to an area of low water concentration. That means that water is going to osmose out of the cell, and the cell is going to shrivel. In the last beaker, we have a hypotonic solution. That means there's less solute in the beaker than there is inside the cell. Again, you can see lots of little purple blue polka dots inside the cell, but almost none in the solution in the beaker. This cell is not at equilibrium with its environment, so membrane transport is going to happen to help us achieve equilibrium. The solute, salt or sugar, can't move. Water is going to move, and it's going to move by osmosis. So water is going to osmose from an area of high water concentration to an area of low water concentration. That means that water is going to osmose into the cell and the cell is going to swell.